This brutalist tower encases the whole, a 333-floor structure with two prisoners on each level.
Por favor, quédese a su lado del hoyo.
If you knew nothing about it except that, some simple maths would suggest it's not a place you'd like to spend a lot of time in. The platform is a Spanish horror thriller about a vertical system where inmates are fed by a floating slab that gradually descends each level. Those below are forced to eat the leftovers of those above until there's nothing left for the people at the very bottom of the literal food chain. I'm going to answer questions like, what's at the bottom of the hole? Who is this? And why panna cotta? So, fair warning, spoilers ahead. It's important to realise that the platform doesn't have a truly evil villain, nor a wholly good hero. The film's director, Galder Gaztelu-Urrutia, has said his work isn't a social critique, but a social self-criticism. It's about the limits of our own empathy, and how hard it is to be a good person at any level of society when what we have is under threat. So, what does the whole represent? Everyone who lives in it is working towards something they desperately want. A diploma, freedom, a cure for cancer. These promises dangle over each prisoner like a carrot, but since most die before they achieve their goals, the system is cruel. Many have pointed out the similarities here to capitalist principles that hard labour leads to reward. But just like young adults saving deposits for a property ladder too tall to ever climb, the hole's inhabitants are stuck in an existence that keeps what they want in sight, but just out of reach.
Vamos, dejadme subir.
Like capitalism, the hole is presented as an opportunity. Goreng must undertake an in-depth interview to enter the system. The director told Collider that Goreng is simply meat for the platform. The administration will accept him no matter what. But that interview is shown as a great opportunity, as a luxury to aspire when it is actually your perdition. I'm sure we've all been through some job interviews like this.
Entonces me han mentido.
Oh no.
Prisoners wake up each month on a random level to symbolise the fact we can't choose the social class we're born into. Our circumstances and wealth, at least to start with, are not earned. Meanwhile, on level zero sit the most privileged, the first world, who create the economy that trickles down into the hole. They're so wrapped up in their pursuit of industry, production and perfection that they're blind to the grey, brutal reality beneath.
¡Estás en la puta mierda!
That reality is inhabited by people like Trimagasu, who represents how greedy individuals fortify corrupt systems. He covets power, resenting both those above him and below him. He takes ownership of whatever he can, even the word obviously.
La conclusión es obvia, ¿no crees?
Me prometió que no iba a volver a usar esa palabra.
And even though he has very little power in the world, he uses what he has to literally piss on others. Goreng's other companion, Imagari, represents Trimagasi's opposite, altruism. Her desire to share wealth is born out of remorse for her privilege when she was part of the administration above and sent people into the hole. But even she doesn't have the answers. Her attempts to change the system are futile, and her previous power has made her prejudiced and racist.
Quería ser la Marilyn Monroe asiática, la hija de puta, con sus ojos rasgados tocando el ukelele.
The platform's lack of a true hero is partly because the filmmakers don't want to suggest socialism or any other system is better. When Goreng and Baharat descend on the platform to share out the food, they brutally beat those too desperate to agree. They force their ideology on every other level and, in the process, kill many of the people they intended to help. Their socialist mission becomes another source of oppression. The platform criticizes capitalism, but it doesn't present an alternative because, really, if it were that easy, society would have probably figured it out by now and the whole movie wouldn't be needed. So what is the point of the platform? Well, Goreng brings a copy of Don Quixote into the hole. Don Quixote is one of the most important works in the Spanish literary canon, the story of a nobleman who decides to become a knight with the grand aspiration of serving his community. But Goreng doesn't just read Don Quixote, he essentially is Quixote. Like his book's character, he's tall and thin, with messy brown hair and a moustache. Both Quixote and Goreng are idealistic and try to change their society's values, but both men often fail.
Es que nadie va a hacer nada!
Actually, the word quixotic, meaning idealistic to an unrealistic or impractical level, comes directly from Don Quixote. Goreng isn't the answer to the whole's injustices, even though his desire to share what he has with the lower levels is noble. It's simply impossible to equally distribute the platform's resources without every level willingly cooperating, and the film shows that to expect that is naive. Those living in the system will be broken by it, as Goring eventually is. He does terrible things to stay alive. That's where the girl comes in. Until we meet her, the message was a panna cotta, and the choice of that delicate dish is important. The filmmakers didn't choose something overwrought or decadent. The message is just sugar and cream. It's a simple message of protest, that something pure can survive in the whole if adults work to protect it. But then we meet the girl. At the end of the film, when the platform is being sent back to level zero, Goring realizes he can't climb on beside the child because his cannibalism and murder makes him too corrupt to ascend with her. She represents total purity, a child at the lowest level of the whole, the bottom of capitalist society, and as such, the most vulnerable person who is totally reliant on those above. It transpires that her mother is Miharu. It's not fully explained, but the suggestion is that Miharu has been travelling the length of the hole to make sure that there's food on the platform for her child. That even an employee of the administration doesn't know a child is on level 333, nor that that level even exists, is the point. Children are often invisible in conflict, famine, and policy. And Imigari's blindness to the extra 133 levels shows how privileged societies are often blithely ignorant of the world's most intense suffering. That Miharu is an immigrant is also key. Both her and her child are mute, emphasizing the way immigrants often move through systems unnoticed, being walked past and even walked over by the countries they move to. Miharu's name has multiple meanings in Japanese. To guard, watch over, and open one's eyes wide. Miharu guards her daughter, who is the message that will one day open the eyes of the administration above. The child represents the belief that future generations have the power to change things so long as we can shield them enough from the system to not become corrupted by it. The girl in the hole is healthy and calm, with the final shot lingering on her ascension into an uncertain future. So where does that leave Goring? Interestingly, the platform's director told Digital Spy that for him, the lowest level doesn't exist. Goring is dead before he arrives. But the girl does exist. They even filmed a different ending showing the girl arriving at the first level, but they took it out of the final cuts. Ultimately, the filmmakers wanted the success of Goring's plan to be uncertain. Like Don Quixote centuries ago, the platform is open to interpretation. Edith Grossman, who translated Don Quixote in 2003, said that the novel has multiple interpretations and can be read both comically and tragically. She says Don Quixote never lets the reader rest. You are never certain that you truly got it, and that's exactly the feeling that the platform evokes. There is no answer in the end, because there is no solution to our current state of society. But there is the possibility that our future generations might find a way, and all we can do is find a way to help them ascend to positions powerful enough to drive that change. For more deep dives into the messages, ideas, and concepts behind your favourite shows, stick around on this Netflix channel.